Now, you see that I emphasize to you, you see, preparing financial statement is not compulsory for sole trade business and partnership. But you see, companies are concerned, preparing financial statement is a legal requirement. It's a legal requirement. So that when we prepare financial statements, definitely we have to follow accounting standard, accounting concepts, accounting presumptions, accounting assumptions, and accounting principles. Understood? When we prepare financial statement of a company, we have to concern accounting standard, accounting concepts, accounting principles, and accounting assumptions. Understand? Definitely we have to
yes, sir.
Accounting.
Sir, isn't it then isn't it better to do the 11th one first and then the 12th one?
No, I feel that it is Dulina now. Computer set 12 is concerned completely practical. Completely practical. So that in my teaching career, every year, first I teach computer set 12 and do some examples, and thereafter I'm going back to computer set 11 so that it is easy for us to understand. Now, here competency 12 prepares financial statements for a limited company. Now, here the concept map introduced in the, that is teacher's guide. Definition of limited company. Legal background associated with accounting of limited companies. You see, Sri Lanka Accounting Auditing Standard Act number 15 of 1980, Accounting and Auditing Act. This is a related act with regard to the companies. The other one is Company Act number 7 of 2007. This is the related act and practical act related to companies. Enacted law. Sri Lanka Auditing Standard. Sri Lanka Auditing Standard. The other one is regulations of Shyama. Now, these are the practical laws and regulations regarding companies. Then you see books and reports maintained by company, by a company. Then you see classification of companies. There are three types of companies that can be established according to Company Act number 7 of 2007. First one is unlimited companies, limited companies, companies limited by guarantee. Unlimited companies means the liability of the company is unlimited. Liability of the company is unlimited. You see now, if you have purchased some shares of an unlimited company, your liability for external people, external liability is unlimited. That is the meaning. Your liability towards external parties is unlimited. We have purchased shares of this unlimited companies. Limited companies are concerned. If you purchase some shares of limited companies, your liability is limited to your share capital. Understood? Your liability is limited to your share capital, the capital that you have invested. Now, companies limited by guarantee. Companies limited by guarantees are concerned. These companies are not issuing shares. These companies are not issuing shares. Instead, if the company is liquidated in future, liquidated or shut down in future, then the external liability should be borne by those shareholders. If the company is liquidated or shut down in future, external liability should be borne by the company shareholders. Those companies are called companies limited by guarantee. Then limited companies, public limited companies, now offshore companies. Offshore companies are, now they are established in Sri Lanka, incorporated in Sri Lanka. Offshore companies are concerned, they are established in Sri Lanka, but they are not doing business in Sri Lanka. Business out of Sri Lanka. That is offshore companies. Foreign companies are concerned, they are established in other countries and they are doing business in Sri Lanka. Only foreign companies. Type of shares. Now, here there is a small mistake. There are three types of shares of a company. Now, all these are business studies. Ordinary shares. First one is ordinary shares. Or equity shares. Preference shares. Specialty shares. Now, this concept is important for you. This concept is important for you. You what you call stated capital. Stated capital. What this stated capital is, a company issues shares to general public to collect fund. Now, companies are concerned, major source of fund is issuing shares to general public. Major source of fund is issuing shares to general public. Share issuing is the major source of fund of a limited company. Then, capital collected by issuing shares is called stated capital. Now, sole trade business is concerned. You see, it is called capital. Non-profit organization is called accumulated fund. Equity means accumulated fund. In a partnership, equity comprises of capital account balance and current account balance. Understood. Companies are concerned. Capital means stated capital. The term stated capital is used for capital. According to section number 58, these are not material, of the Company Act, stated capital means, now here stated capital means, the total of cash received and receivable by the company on issue of shares. When issuing shares, received cash and receivable cash on issue of shares is called stated capital. Per share capital consideration. You see, per share consideration means, you see, price of a share. Per share consideration means price of a share. If the price of a share is concerned, that is the term is consideration. Consideration or per share consideration, which is called price of a share. Price of a share. Based on section number 52 of the Company Act, the board of directors decide the per share is the issuing value of the share. Per share, which is the issuing value of the share. So that according to Company Act, share price is decided by the board of directors. When the board of directors is issuing shares to the general public, per share consideration, issuing price of a share is decided by the company directors or board of directors. Different ways of receiving the shares, per share consideration. You can get it as cash, or you can get it as promissory note, or you can get it as future property or other securities. Now look at that consideration. Per share consideration, method of collection, cash, as cash you can collect, as property you can collect, as other security you can collect, or future services. Instead of paying cash, you can supply future services to cover up the share capital. Collecting at once, you can collect this amount at once, or you see, twice or thrice. In Sri Lanka, practically, you see the total of consideration is collected at once. We are discussing in our accounting discussion. We discuss a collection of that is cash at once, not, you see, parts and parts. In journal and post them to ledger accounts. Now, for example, here there are two concepts of two occasions where a company can issue shares. Now, companies can issue in two shares in two situations. First one is initial public offer. Initial public offer means, you know that in the Colombo Stock Exchange, there are two boards. In the Colombo Stock Exchange, which is responsible for issuing shares, companies are issue, you see, companies are listed in the Colombo Stock Exchange. Thereafter, these companies can issue shares to general public when only companies are listed in the Colombo Stock Exchange. Colombo Stock Exchange is the legal body that is responsible for companies issuing shares. Then you see, first you see, any public limited company should get listed in the Colombo Stock. Get listed in the sense that there are two lists in the Colombo Stock Exchange. First one is main board. The other one is Dirisavi board. Main board, Dirisavi board. Any public limited company to issue shares, it has to get listed either in the main board or in the Dirisavi board. They have to get listed in the either in the main board or in the Dirisavi board. Now, after getting listed in the Colombo Stock Exchange, immediately, if the company issues shares to general public, that is called initial public offer. Immediately after get listed in the Colombo Stock Exchange, if the company is issued to general public, that is called initial public offer. Then after getting listed, sometimes you see second time or third time, if the company is issuing shares, that is what you call offer for sale. Now this part is very important for accounting, because this is how you have to record it. First one, journal entries on issue of shares. First one is cash debit, share issue account credit. Cash debit. Now double entry is very important. When you receive cash on issue of shares, total of cash amount should be debited. So that cash amount debit, you see, credited to a special account which is called share issue account. It's okay?
Yes, sir.
Then narration is receiving cash on application. Application means when you apply for purchasing shares. Second one, you see, when you record second time, second entry should be made, share issue account debit, stated capital credit. Now this is the second journal entry. This is what you call allotment of shares, which means shares are allotted or distributed among shareholders. That is second time. Sometimes you see, assume that we issue shares. Now per share is 100. The stated capital value is how much? Total of the stated capital? 1000. Because yes, number of shares issued 100. Per share value is, that is 10. So that total amount is 1000. Now, sometimes you see, though the company issues 100 shares, applicants may send 150 shares. We issue shares only for 100. But applicants may send applications for 150 shares. So that with that money, we receive how much of money? 1,500, is it? Then if we receive 1,500, we can capitalize only 1,000. This excess money should be sent back to the applicants. Understand? Excess money should be sent back to the applicants. You see, this is how you have record. Cash, how much of cash received by us due to this transaction? 1,500. Then cash account debit, what is credited? Share issue account credit. Then you have to capitalize only 1,000. So that second one, you see, share issue account debit 1,000, and then stated capital credit 1000. Sorry, 1000. Now, when you return excess money, SHA XU account debit how much? 500. Then cash credit 500. Now what happened? Look at the example. First one, cash debit, SHA XU account credit. Now here SHA XU account credit. I cut it off. Then SHA XU account debit 1000, SHA XU account debit 500. You know what happened to then SHA XU account? Comes to any?
The SHA XU account, it cancels out, right?
Cancel out, yes, cancel out. You see, SHA XU account credit, here SHA XU account debit 10, 500 debit, cancel off. After, yes. After recording the SHA transaction, then SHA XU account comes to an end. It is a temporary account.
Yes.
And then you see what happened. Cash debit 1500 remains. And then here cash credit 1500 remains. End result is how much of cash remains? 1000.
Yes.
1000. Here 1500 debit. Here 1500 credit. Closing balance is 1000. Right. Now look at that first one. I'll show the answer very simply. Now, first one is concerned here. You see cash account debit 4,800. And then SHA XU account credit 4,800. And then receiving cash on application recorded. Second one, SHA XU account debit, how much? 4,000. And then stated capital credit, how much? 4,000. Then narration is being allotment of shares recorded. Being allotment of shares recorded. Then you see excess money should be returned back. Excess money should be returned back. So that share issue account debit, how much? 800. Excess money is 800. And then cash account credit, how much? 800. Being excess money returned, recorded. Being excess money returned, recorded.
Thank you.
Only PLC issues shares on 1st January 2020 to receive cash on application. Consideration per share was 60. Following details are given for you. Now, these are the subscribers who applicants. Description. Applied shares. Existing shareholders in the company. Already these existing shareholders has applied. Have applied 50 shares. Now, they were allotted one-to-one. One-to-one means those who applied 50, 50 were given. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
One-to-one. And then employees of the company demanded applied 200,000 shares. If 200,000 shares are applied, you see, if two shares are applied, given only one share, allotted only one share.
Yes,
so
sir.
Here 200 shares were requested, but they were given only 100. Local business and other persons are concerned, you see, that is 3-to-1. And then total number of shares, that is 600, is it? Total of number of 600. Then allotted number of shares is, that is 260, is it? 260. Then cash received on application, 600 into 60 means 36,000. How much is return? 240 into 60. First one is generally is concerned. Cash account debit 36,000. Cash account debit 36,000. Share issue account credit 36,000. Share issue account credit 36,000. First one is concerned. Cash debit 36,000 and then share issue account. Share issue account. How much is 36,000? First one is concern. And then how much of general entry for returning? General entry for returning is concern. Share issue account. Share issue account debit. Share issue account debit. How much? 14,400. And then credit cash. 14,400. See whether having problems. Capitalizing this capitalizing share issue how much 260 into 15,000 15,600 and then stated capital. Stated capital credit 15,600. See whether it is okay for you.
Yes, sir.
Here, general entry is concerned. Narration is concerned. B, cash receipt on share issue application record. B, cash receipt on application record. Cash receipt on application record. Here, being excess money returned, recorded. Being excess money returned, recorded. Being excess returned, recorded. Being share issue capitalized. Being share issue capitalized. Here, being share issue capitalized. Ruan is an employee. He received 5,000 shares. But the amount of money sent by Ruan on application. Ruan is an employee. As employees are concerned, 2:1. Then, Ruan should shares what is the amount of money sent by Ruan on application. Then, Ruan was given 5,000 shares. 2:1, which means he should send how many applications?
600,000.
He should send 10,000 applications. Per application, per share, is that is 60. Per share is 60. Then total is how much? That is 60. That's all. Then if T0 omitted, that is 600. 600. Then amount, then the answer is, Ruan is an employee, he received 5,000 shares. What are the amount of money sent by Ruan on application? That is 600,000. Next one, a local businessman received 3,000 shares. Businessmen, local businessmen are concerned, what the value? local businessman 3:1. 3:1 means then he should receive how much? That is here, then the total of money sent by him, that should be 9 shares. They should apply 9,000 shares. Then only 3,000 allotted, and then remaining should be returned back. How much? 6,000 into 60. Another area we are going to discuss. Now there is another concept, man. Rights share issue and capitalizing reserve. You see, then you have to understand why, what these rights share issues are. And you have to identify what these capitalizing reserves are. Now, rights share issues are concerned here. Rights share issue. Issuing shares to existing ordinary shareholders on a certain proportion, charging money. Right share means, you see, issuing shares to existing shareholders. Just keep in mind, issuing shares to existing ordinary shareholders, charging money. Charging money. You see, now, when right shares are issued, the board of directors can decide the per share consideration. Per share consideration means issuing price. And then when considering the, when deciding the per share consideration, you see, it should not be injustifiable to existing shareholders. To existing shareholders, they should decide the per share consideration without making any abnormality towards the existing shareholders according to the Company Act. And then, very simply, right share issue means issuing shares to the existing shareholders charging money. And then capitalizing reserves means, you see, it is also a kind of share issue to the existing shareholders only, but without charging money. Without charging money. Now, in a company, equity comprises of 4 proportions. Equity of a partnership comprises of 4 components. First one is, you see, now this is how you have to identify the equity of a company. Now, just try to understand equity of a company. Now, there are four elements of equity. First one is stated capital. And then you see another part is general reserve. The other one is what you call revaluation reserve. Another one is revaluation reserve. The other one is what you call retained earn. Equity of a company comprises of four components. First one is stated capital, general reserve, revaluation reserve, retained earn. Understand? Equity comprises of four components. First one is what you call stated capital, and then general reserve, and then revaluation reserve, and then retained earn. Four parts are there. Now, this is how equity comprises of four areas. That is stated capital, general reserve, revaluation reserve, retained earn. Now, these three reserves are concerned. You see, these are what you call undivided profit. Normally, profit of a company should be shared among shareholders. Profit of the company should be shared among shareholders. In the end of the period, you see, it is the sharing of profit is decided by the board of directors. Board of directors can take a decision of over this, that is sharing of profit. You see, reserves means unshared profit. Reserve means, you see, profit which is not shared among partners. There are three types of reserves. These are called reserves. Reserve is a portion of profit which is not shared among partners, among shareholders. It is not shared gain. So that is what you call unshared profit of the company. You see, this unshared reserve is owned by the company, not by the shareholders. Understand? According to what you call the concepts, according to entity concept, company is a separate entity, shareholders are separate entities. According to entity concept, company is a separate entity, separated from the shareholders, and shareholders are separated from, that is, companies. So that stated company is owned by shareholders. Stated capital is owned by shareholders. These three shares are owned by the company, not by shareholders. These three shares are company equity. Stated capital is shareholders' equity normally. So that now capitalizing reserve means what we call bonus share issue. Capitalizing reserve means bonus share issue. Capitalizing reserve means very simply, you see, capitalizing reserves. Capitalizing these reserves. Now, certain amount of this reserve value is transferred to stated capital. That is only capitalization of reserves, which means, you see, company equity is transferred to shareholders' equity. That is what you call capitalizing reserves. So that capitalizing reserves can be decided by the board of directors according to the capacity of the business. Then this is how right shares is concerned, double entries. Right shares is concerned, cash account debit, or share stated account credit. Bonus share is concerned, relevant reserve account debit, ordinary shares stated capital credit. Now, here you see capitalizing reserve means issuing shares to existing ordinary shareholders free of charge using the reserve of the company. That is the meaning of ordinary, that is bonus share issue. Now look at this example. Examine the differences between rights share issue and capitalizing reserves. Difference is that you can write it down if you need. Cash flow is concerned, rights share issue is concerned, there is a cash flow. There is a cash flow. Because rights share issue is concerned here, rights share issue means issuing shares to existing ordinary shareholders on a certain proportion, charging money. So that there is a cash flow in issuing rights share issues. Capitalizing reserves means no money is charged. So that here cash flow, there is a cash flow, no cash flow, no cash flow. Total equity. Due to total equity, due to right share issue, total equity increases. Total equity increases. Because here you see, ordinary share increases. Ordinary share credit means increases. Right share issue. Due to capitalizing reserves, now this is also equity. This is also equity. State capital means equity. Reserve means equity. So that no change, no increase or decrease in equity. Because what happened is that reserve amount is transferred to stated capital only. There is no inflow of cash or inflow of extra capital. Can you understand?
Yes, sir.
So that total equity increases, no increase, no increase. Use of reserves, no. No. Yes. Yes. Capitalizing reserves, yes. Number of shareholders, no change because both are issued to existing shareholders. Both are issued to existing shareholders. So that there is no increase of number of shareholders. No change, no change. No change, no change. Examine the similarities, right shares and capital. Similarity is that what? Similarity, both are issued to existing shareholders, ordinary shareholders. Both are issued to existing ordinary shareholders. Both are issued to existing ordinary shareholders. It's a similarity. Both are issued to existing shareholders. Second one.
Yes.
Both are issued to existing ordinary shareholders. Number of shareholders doesn't change. Number of shareholders doesn't change.
Okay.
Number of shares is concerned, if you omit T zeros, number of shares are 1,000. Sorry, 100. Value of shares, that is 4,000. Now here it is said that now these are the three reserves: revaluation reserve, general reserve, and the retained. It is not 3,500. It should be 8,000. It should be 8,000. It's wrong. Then you see, 1st January 2020, the board of directors decided then capitalizing reserves for the proportion of 4:1. 4:1 means. Then you see here, the number of shareholders 100 and they divided by 4. Then what is the capitalizing reserve value? 25. Because you see each shareholder, if the shareholder is having 4 shares, he is given single share. Total number of shares 100. So that allotted bonus shares, that is 25. Per share consideration is how much? 40. then 45 into 25 into 40. How much is the total allotment? 1,000. 1,000.
Yes, sir.
Then double entries. What? Normally, when you capitalize reserve, first you have to use retained earning account. Retained earning account. So the double entry is that retained earning account debit 1,000, stated capital credit 1,000. Retained earning account debit 1,000. I write the double entry. Retained earning account retained earning debit, how much? 1,000. And then stated capital, credit 1,000. Capitalizing reserves. Second one is concerned issue of right shares for ordinary shares existed before capitalizing reserves based on the proportion of 5:1. So that before capitalizing reserves, we were having 100 shares and then divided by 5. And then you are given how much? There is 20 bonus right share issue, number of right shares is that is 20. Then per share consideration is 50. Here it is given that per share consideration is 50. Then total of share issue is that is once again 1,000. Number of shareholders 100,000. Each 5 shareholder is given a single right share. So that if five shareholder is given a single right share, then you see those who are having 100 shares, they are given 20 right shares. Per share consideration is 50, so that 100. Double entry, general entries, cash debit, stated capital credit. Cash debit, stated capital credit. We completed that part as well. Past journal entries, post them to ledger accounts. Did you prepare the ledger accounts?
I'm writing them now, sir.
Yes, we are doing it now. Then post them into ledger account is concerned. Then first, all this should be taken as your opening balances. My ordinary share account, stated capital account, opening balance, credit, 4,000. See whether it is okay?
Yes, sir.
Now, revaluation reserve, credit balance, opening balance, 1,000. General reserve, opening balance, 5,000. Retained earning, opening balance, 2,000. Now, due to this share issues, first one is retained earning account, debit, then capital account, stated capital, credit. Second one, cash debit, stated capital credit. Now, after issuing of shares, both shares, order share capital number of share 145,000. Because here 25, here 20, total is 125.
Yes, sir.
New number of, total of share value is ordinary share value is that is 6,000. 6,000.
Yes, sir.
Revaluation reserve no change. General reserve no change. Here Retained earnings is concerned only 1,000. Only 1,000. Because you are asked to prepare an extract of the statement of financial position. Extract is concerned here 145,000, here 6,000, here 1,000 remain unchanged, here 5,000 remain unchanged, here it becomes 1,000.